Welcome to the Boerma Institute. My name is Jacqueline Boerma. I'm going to give a demonstration today with a beautiful vase I found at the wholesaler this week. So, and it's, I think it's my favorite color. So I'm going to make an arrangement in it. I placed an oasis pin holder inside with some fix and then a piece of floral foam, biodegradable, 91% biodegradable foam, and a little piece of chicken wire. So I'm going to use some nice dill, some grasses, some antirrhinum, some papavers, and I have much more stuff here. So I also have some buddleia, which is cut from my garden this morning. And it has been soaking up some water. And hydrangea also from my garden. Look how beautiful the head is. Some echinacea. I bought that at the wholesaler, which has a lovely orangey pinky color. And that color comes back into the antirrhinums. I also have some astilbe, but I'm not very happy with the astilbe because it started to hang a little bit. But I used the Floralife water inside, so I'm hoping they will survive. And then I have some menta. So it's a nicely perfumed arrangement with my dill and my menta. Then I have some leaves as well, some Monstera leaves, some ruscus, Italian ruscus there. So I've cut quite a few materials. Here you go, eucalyptus. And I'm just starting with some Monstera. So today we have to do without Mike and Angelica, because they're in Virginia together with Holly, with Holly Chapel. They are giving a course there, a special one. They will come out, they will come back on Sunday. And then they're almost straight off to holiday. And then they go to Greece, so very nice. Using the ruscus, taking off the leaves that go into the water, making it looking towards that side there. And then I can use some eucalyptus to the other side, more or less two-thirds, not completely opposite, but about two-thirds of the arrangement. There, place that on the side for a moment. I have used chicken, I'm using chicken wire as well, so that means that I cannot build up from straight up and then down, but I'm going to start from my horizontal part to my vertical part. And I'm crisscrossing the stems. See, unfortunately, what I do is when I order flowers, I order them online, so I can't see the quality anymore. We used to have a very nice wholesale center here in Aalsmeer, Cultra, but already a couple of years we don't have that anymore. So we have to buy online, which sometimes does not make me very happy. Sometimes it does, but sometimes it's not. So a Monstera leaf on the other side. Oops. Taking off some leaves. So welcome everybody. I hope you will enjoy the demo. Please let me know where you come from. If you are there, if anybody is there, just give a shout out and then let me know where you're from. The viburnum, of the viburnum, in my horen. The buddleia is holding up very nicely. It was broken when I cut it off, but it was still all right. So it's not completely broken, so probably just bent. And I will use it as it is, because it still has a nice curve in it. And I'll just turn it around. Some nice mint to go with it. Getting ready for summer. So, a nice minty cocktail, maybe. So I'm here today with Axel behind the second camera, and with Sin, who is doing the questions, who will see your questions, and she will tell me what you're asking or saying, and then that's her voice. So Sin is doing the talking today. If you have something to ask, of course. Using some grasses to give a little bit more height and a little bit more airiness to the arrangement. And because I'm using just a little bit of foam at the base, I can already go quite high, even though without having a lot of stems at the base. Yesterday evening we had a nice club. So once a month, mostly Dutch people, Dutch students, former students, we come together, and then we have the DFD study club. That means that every month we decide on a theme, and then we have a nice evening starting at 7, and then everybody comes in and everybody takes something with them from home. So every month we decide the theme together, and yesterday our theme was beach. So what I got was this one. So everybody could use this base. And it was, Axel made two screws in the wall. And then they could use this, and they could let it stand on the table, or they could hang it. So they had several options to do that. And I shared it on Facebook. Aneta always makes a nice movie out of the photos and the films she does. And then you can share that, you can see that on my Facebook page. And then for the September edition, we have this Oasis Bridal Foam Eco Base Lady, heart shaped. And we will use that. It doesn't have to be like a bridal bouquet. Anybody can use their own imagination to use that. So they will take the cover or the base where they will put it in, and then we as Boerma Institute we buy the flowers and the materials, so and everybody can work together. We don't make it at home, but we make it at the school. So the person from the Boerma Institute, who normally is a teacher, is not the teacher this time, but just an assistant and walking around and helping if needed. So it's not a class, it's a club. And I'm using some echinacea just to give a nice pop of color on the outside. And I will repeat it, a little bit more there, on this side. And now it's already getting a little bit full, so it's more difficult to put it in. And I was thinking I had some more, yeah. I can use one more there on that side, so it's not so lonely. And then I'm using the dill. Oh, I broke that one, sorry. And in the other classroom today, we have Gerald. Gerald is teaching the funeral work course, level 2. So they are making a coffin arrangement and an arrangement with some branches this morning. And yesterday I was teaching them and we made a funeral cross on an oasis base and an urn decoration. So we also have 2 days courses. It's for people can do that for hobby. Most of the time they don't do the funeral work for hobby, but you can though, because in Holland, when you make a funeral arrangement, you can also use it for other occasions like a table decoration or even an event decoration, maybe something for church. So different opportunities. Oh, that one might be a little bit short, it's broken. Let me repeat that on the opposite side. Then I can use some more. Papaver. So this is the final live stream before the school has their summer break. And we'll start in September again. In August, Mike will also go to the Czech Republic, to Patrick, where Patrick has a flower shop in Pardubice. And Mike will teach the ladies over there for hand-tied bouquets and things like that. So we also do trips where we help flower shop owners with their staff. We train their staff members. We like to go abroad. So next year in November we go to EFD again. That's the European Flower Design, where we work with together in Japan. They have, I think, about 87,000 students and about 1,500 teachers. So we make arrangements for them as well, and that will be in the lesson book. And then about 6,000 students have to make the same arrangement in about a week. So from top to bottom of Japan, 6,000 students make our arrangements, which is actually very nice to do. And in November, we also have, or October actually, October we have our sister school. I think Mike calls it sister school. Coming over to Holland, and we will give lessons to them. And that's just prior to the International Master Education with Gregor Lers. And Gregor is coming over in November again, and then in March 2024 to teach the International Master, which Mike and I have done 2 years, last year. We finished and we passed the exam. Some more grass is here horizontal, so it's a little bit more airy there as well. If there are any questions, please ask. Sin, we have somebody in the chat or not?
No, we don't.
J- just adding a little bit more grasses in between, not too much, just a little bit see-through. Oops, there you go, see-through. I was thinking, shall I use this one or not? Maybe. I think this is nice. This is a beautiful allium from All I Am. We had that with the Floral Fundamentals weekend. Then we had open house and we had a lot of growers open as well. I will use that one and that one in the other arrangement. Let's see, maybe I can use a beautiful peony. And I think I will use two on this side. And then, yeah, let me use this one. This one is nicely open. So, and then the yellow of the petals here, they come back into the yellow of the dill. Yes, please.
Yes, we have Shield Maiden saying that is looking beautiful.
Thank you very much. Thank you for joining as well. Yeah, so I give it a little bit more depth here at the bottom. And then, see? And it's nice pop of color at the bottom there. And one smaller one above it. Like that. And then it still needs a little bit. So let me check out what I still have. I have some cotinas. Somebody used already some tops, but I will use it a little shorter. And then I think I can manage to get it in at the base here as well. Yes, please.
Yes, Shield Maiden is saying amazing rich colors.
Thank you very much. I love the colors. This is most of the time my autumn color, my autumn winter color for Christmas. I have a lot of Christmas decorations in this color, but I found these peonies and I had to work with them, so I love them. Oh yeah, let's not forget that I still have some clematis from Martin Parr. They're already also a little bit older, but still surviving very well. So it's a good quality flower. And I will use that a little bit to the outside to get a little bit more horizontal parts there. And then underneath the peony, it can also use a little bit more. And of course there's water in there, eh? Water with Floralife. So it has some extra vase life. Does it work? Not completely. I touched something there. Maybe another stem. Or maybe some chicken wire. Yep. Taking off the leaves also here, so it doesn't evaporate too much from the leaves. Yep. And then I think the arrangement is ready. So So what do you think? I hope you like it. Just showing it around for you.
Yes. Shield Maiden is asking, are these colors and blooms readily available?
Yes. They sell the mint at the auction, the Echinacea as well. But Leia is from my garden, so they don't sell that at the auction. But they also sell the Anthurium and the grasses at the auction. Because Martin Parr, they import, they have materials from Kenya and so on. They have very nice, they grow very nice grasses as well. The peonies are from Holland still, from our open house. And the deal comes also from the auction. So yes, everything is widely available here in Holland. Can you please take it? Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much. This is my second arrangement. I was thinking yesterday, I was thinking more classic arrangement yesterday. Until this morning, because this morning Gerard arrived and he had a hibiscus shrub in his garden, which didn't survive very well. So he cut it down and then he said, maybe we can use it for the funeral arrangements today. And I said, maybe I like it a lot for my table decoration as well. So here I am. I'm using the double brick from Oasis, biodegradable foam, and the branch from Gerald. So I'm very happy with that. Yeah.
Yes, Shield Maiden was saying thank you on the previous question.
Oh, you're welcome. My pleasure. Please ask if you want to know something. Just ask. I'm making a kind of horizontal arrangement at the moment because it will be a table decoration. So I'm using some formium underneath or in between my branches. And then it's not connected yet to my floral foam base, but it will be in a second. What did I do with the ends? I dropped them, sorry. Hello. I want to use my bottom pieces of the formium also at the end of my base. So it's going to be more or less one direction.
Shield Maiden is saying, ooh, sticks, my favorite.
Yeah, they're so nice, huh? You can do so much with them. So I'm using this bottom pieces of the arrangement. On the other side. And I'm just getting some more materials. Some more peonies. And some leucodendron. Some fatsias and some asparagus. It's going to be a table arrangement, so it's going to be for a wider table, not my size table, but a little bit wider. But it still needs to be not too far to the other side, not too far out. So what I do is I keep my arrangement quite thin, so people can still have their plates on the table. And it's not too much in the way. Hey, My hair is getting loose. I have just a little bun at the back, but I felt like it was getting loose. I'm using the materials in groups. And I'm using Asparagus cetaceus, Asparagus cetaceus. So I use the asparagus on three parts. And then I will also use some cotinus, which I love to go with it. And here in Holland we call it a wig tree. You can probably understand why. So the color of the formium comes back again. Don't know why it's doing that. This morning it was fine. Using a little bit of the pinkish color again as well. Let me see, where do I do that? There. This is also a leucodendron. So you can see that a lot of materials are used quite short to the base. I like that one there. So these are peonies from my Peony Society. I love the color. And when I turn it around, you can see why. It does magic. And I'll use the same ones on this side. This can go now. I will use that later. Then I have another hydrangea from my garden to give a lighter color than the peony. And then I have some beautiful roses. There, how beautiful they are. And then I have some more yellow of the Alchemilla. And I have some darker pink of the Dianthus. Oh, I didn't clean that. Dianthus barbatus. And I have some shorter ones of the Antirrhinum. Yeah.
Yes, we have Shield Maiden. And he says, I love your used sticks. They give great structure and give a great contrast to most blooms. I think they create a great synergistic balance.
Thank you very much. That's lovely to hear. I'm happy that you like it. I think they give a lot of air without using too many flowers. So it doesn't have to be a very expensive arrangement. It can be just very airy. And it's also a good use, of course, of the materials. Otherwise, people would throw them away. And now we're reusing them. Beautiful, eh? It's the the rose is called Happiness, so it's Venturosa. That's the name of the rose. So this rose makes me happy. It has quite a thick stem, but it has a beautiful head, and I think it will be more beautiful when it opens up. I just had them yesterday coming in, but if you have them a little bit longer, I think they're more beautiful because they will open up very nicely. And they have a beautiful heart as well because it's all rolled up. You can see that it has a lot of potential. Some more, I think some more Antirrhinum on the opposite side. Just have to turn my arrangement. It's getting a little bit more difficult here with my stuff on the table. Let me see if I can make that right. Oops. Oh yeah. And what I forgot this time, normally I say that to my students, whenever you work and you have such a lot of materials inside the container, then when you have your Oasis bricks already completely full, it weighs about 1.6 or 1.8 kilo. That means it has a lot of water. So when you push the stems in, sometimes water comes out. So what you do is you drain it a little bit so your table does not get completely wet. And Axel is having fun, eh, Axel? Mm-hmm. Axel has the second camera, so he's quite busy today with this and not with the shop. We have also an online web shop, and Axel is renewing that web shop. So we ship all over the world, I think. Mm-hmm. Where did you get your last order from? Was that... Not Belgium, right? It was a little bit further away.
New Zealand.
New Zealand. We had an order from New Zealand. So, yeah, we ship all over the world. And it will be new. When will the new one be online?
Hopefully in 2 weeks.
So hopefully in 2 weeks we will have the new web shop online. Let's have some mint as well. Oops. And some more echinacea. Oh, it smells so nice. So what kind of cocktail is in with the mint? mint and lime. What was that cocktail? Mojito. Mojito. Yeah, yeah. So can we have that later?
Sure. Oh.
Yeah, go ahead.
We have Lila Marinas saying beautiful piece.
Thank you very much, Lila. Look how beautiful the echinacea is as well. Yeah. I think we have another question coming up.
Another question. Shield Maiden says, I'm in England. Many florists have a classic style. My florist is very much done in the Dutch way. It must be my Dutch heritage.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yes, you're right. A lot of English florists, they have a classic way of flower arranging. We do it a little bit different here in Holland. We use a lot of different styles. Also during our professional course, we do a lot of different styles and techniques. So you can learn a lot during those 5 weeks. We also have an advanced course and a master course. So and we're still learning. So I like to have a long lifelong learning. And it's also promoted by the Dutch government, by the way. So they want to have everybody working until they're 67 nowadays. Huh? Some dill at the bottom of the base. Oops, got stuck. That's okay, they know we have a live stream. The students from the funeral work course, I think they are ready. So they're walking in the hallway. Oh, I love these roses. Happiness. So what's that in Portuguese, Sin? Happiness, what is it in Portuguese? It's behind you, it's Venturoso. That's the name of the rose. Don't forget. Love these. So let's have them also to this side, just because we can. I told the students that they could have a peek later when they are ready, so be prepared that they're coming in.
Yeah. Shield Maiden is asking, where can I find your courses?
Oh, it's very simple. It's DutchFloralDesign.com or it's Burma.nl. We don't have any online courses. We only have the online live stream like this. But our courses are in Aalsmeer in the Netherlands. And we have, sorry about that. And we are very close to Schiphol Airport. It's only 8 minutes. So from England, it's just a small step. I think if you travel inside the UK, I think sometimes you have to fly longer to another destination in the UK than when you go to Holland. I thought I had some other kinds of leaves as well. Let me check. Oh yeah, sure I had. I have another Monstera. That's nicely underneath my peony. Yeah, go ahead.
Shield Maiden is saying, I bet that smells great. I think the roses.
Yes, it does, it does. me get the leaf, let me wire this leaf so I can have it a little shorter. I'll just use a 0.9 wire, make a hairpin, fold my leaf, double it, and then wire it like this. If you can't see it, come and join the course, then we'll show it very closely. And then put it in. Yep. Then I have some more cotinus. I will cover that piece of foam here. And then I need another piece of dill. Then I think this piece is closed. This piece is covered. Do I need something else? Maybe. Let me see what else I still have. Nope, that's not what I want. I still have a little hydrangea. Just a little bit of light under the dark of my peony. Otherwise everything is getting too dark. That, then I'll turn it around for you. Maybe I can also dry my table. And then I check out the opposite side. So if you have any questions for me regarding courses or whatever you like to ask, please do so. Together with the Floral Fundamentals, the Growers Association, and wholesalers, and our school, we will go to the World Championships in Manchester in September. So hopefully we can meet there. I have a little bit of onions left. Those are lovely. Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, Shield Maiden is saying stunning.
Thank you very much. Some Dianthus, Dianthus barbatus. Just another dark pink to go in the arrangement. In a group as well. Yeah.
Shield Maiden is asking where in Manchester?
I think it's called Manchester Central. Is that, does that ring a bell? Is that an exposition hall or something? I still need a little bit something. Yeah, there it is. I was looking for that. Some more Alchemilla. Then I have some lighter color underneath my peonies on this side as well.
Shield Maiden is asking, are the details on your website?
About the championships? No, not yet. The details about our courses are on our website though. I think you can find it on floralfundamentals.com. It's I think it's from the 7th until the 9th of September. What do you think, Axel? Is that too high or not? Is that okay? I will place it here. Just at the base of my peony. Yeah, now Mike is not here, so you have to be my eyes from the other side, right? So I'm using these alliums. I think it's garlic. I smell garlic though. So, and it will also hang over the arrangement, so it follows the line of the branches that Gerald so nicely brought. You have a question?
No.
But you have a. You were shaking your.
Yes, Shield Maiden is saying thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Then just some more pop of. Yeah, it's definitely garlic. So I have dill and garlic and mint. So I have a very feeling like dinner already. Like, interesting time to eat. Using some more cotinus. And the last bit of cotinus. Yep. And I think, well, I used all my roses. Oh yeah, I made, that's why I remember. I made a small bouquet this morning using the Venturosa roses, so that's why I don't have that many in my arrangement. We also give hand tie bouquet courses. This is one of the bouquets that we do for the first lesson, actually, first lesson day of level one, and also we do that with the professional course. So this is a mixed hand tie bouquet with the stems all spiral in one direction. And I'm left-handed, but I make this bouquet always as a right-handed person because I show so many times as a right-handed person, I can take it, I can do it both ways. So sometimes comes very handy. So using dill, roses, some alstroemeria and some spirea in this bouquet. And when you make a good bouquet, a good hand-tied bouquet, then with a mixed bouquet, it should be able to stand on its own feet as well. So nice practice for the first day of the professional course. Yeah.
Yes, Shield Maiden is saying all you need is some time.
Yes, definitely. Time and fun, because it is fun to do so. When you will have a look on our website or our Instagram or YouTube, you will find also photos of our work that we do during the professional course, Advanced and Master. But you will also see photos shared of the arrangement. So sometimes we also have some more close-ups of the arrangements, because with the live stream you see a lot, but you see only the overview most of the times. Sin makes shortcuts, right? How do you call these?
Edited versions.
So in the edited version you can also see some more close-ups, and you can also see the letter names. So if you have missed the letter names of a couple of the materials that I used. You can later on find that in our edited versions. I think this is ready. So I hope you enjoyed. Please share our YouTube channel with each other, and see you in the like, subscribe, and
hit the bell button.
Thank you very much. So, see you next time. Thank you very much. Bye bye. Komen jullie nog gedag zeggen? Will you say goodbye?